Good afternoon all. My name is Anita Jason. I'm here to present my topic on online identity theft on the internet and its different consequences. Before going to my topic, let me introduce what is identity theft. Identity theft is a proof of someone's existence or the personal information. And theft means it's an unlawful possession without the consent of its owner. Or it can be also tell that it is a person's information steal by any person. And it's also called identity fraud. Identity theft is often perceived a major upcoming threats in crime. Online identity theft occurs when someone spurs your digital documents or personal information using scams like planting malicious software on your devices, collecting information through fraud calls, text messages, OTP frauds, and using your information through your social media accounts, etc. Next. We ourselves are sometimes victim. It may be our fault, or maybe unknowingly we are also be the part of this, because we all have the habits of surfing on some forms or some downloading some contents, and this will be a major problem that we will the scammers will be taking our information for any type of illegal activities. There are some main types of online identity theft, like mail identity theft, social security number identity theft, biometric identity theft, online banking identity theft, social media account identity theft, photo video identity theft, scam calls, remote access identity theft, and next skimming, malware, hacking, fake online profiles, online scams, imposters, farming, and synthetic identity thefts. These are some major identity theft which is reporting all around us. And also, in all the times, these type of scammers will all collect our information from the disciplines we will waste as our bills or receipts, etc. Now it's will all come to us digitalized, and then these hackers will utilize all our personal informations to infect our devices, etc. Next. And here are some sections which is punishable under online identity theft. Mainly section 66C of IT Act, which prescribes of identity theft and provides that anyone who fraudulently or dishonestly make use of any electronic signatures, password, or unique identification features of any person shall be punished with imprisonment and description for it will be punishable for 3 years, and also we need to pay 1 lakh rupees as fine. And also the same as 66D of IT Act prescribes punishment of cheating by person using computer source. It doesn't mean only computer, it can be any type of devices used for communication. And section 149 also of IPC also prescribes for cheating by a personal documents. And it can also be punishable for 3 years or fine or both. And when we are focusing on the law relating offense of identity theft, the term identity theft is defined in section 378 of Indian Penal Code, and also section 463, 464, 465, 469, and 474 of IPC has provisions of punishing forgery or identity theft has also been added the ambit of the provisions following modification of IPC in 1960s. Next. How to detect online identity theft? We need to check our personal accounts on a regular basis and deal with any anomalies of as soon as possible. Also, we need to don't use any websites with the bad reputation, and maintain our email security email protocol. And only download software from reputable sources and install most recent Windows, and also take most cautious where using public computers, and use antivirus software and firewall to keep your computer safe. These are some prevention methods you to keep devices from online identity thefts. Next. Here I am explaining about some impacts of online identity theft. It can damage our credit cards, and it may be affect our social security number, and also they will use our account for these types of frauds, and they will never pay the amount back, and it will be affecting our credit history, and for as the impact of this, our ability of the credit card score will be very less. And then tax debits. If some assumes your identity through SSN of job application and that it does not pay back their taxes, so you should end up with the hefty bills. And also some criminal records. If someone uses your identity to commit other crimes and give your information to the police, then they were arrested. And next, loss of time and money. It also take lots of time for your time, and it will expenses incurred in the theft of time of work. Next. And here it's conclusion. As the rapid growingly social issues, identity theft is one of a major crime that is threatening individuals and the organization worldwide. And also thieves, fraudulents, and criminals use various methods to obtain personal information. The variety of technique is used to obtain the personal identification as well as amount of profits. The introduction of this new technologies and the people's lack of knowledge is to protect their personal information and motivating fraudulence. As a result, increase people awareness how to protect themselves on the networks through media education is critical. And hereby, this presentation will give you an awareness how to use our personal information and how to be protected from this online identity theft. Thank you.